We want to solve the given trig equation for x. Notice how this equation contains both x and y, so we'll be able to write x in terms of y. We'll start by isolating secant 3x. So we'll start by subtracting square root 5 on both sides of the equation. This is 0, so we have 2 times secant 3x equals y minus the square root of 5. And now we'll divide both sides by 2. This simplifies to 1 secant 3x, or just secant 3x. On the right side, we just have the quantity y minus the square root of 5, all divided by 2. And now from here, to solve for x, we'll take inverse secant on both sides of the equation. Notice how inverse secant and secant will undo each other. So we'll have inverse secant of secant 3x equals inverse secant of y minus the square root of 5 divided by 2. So again, inverse secant of secant 3x will simplify nicely just to 3x. So we have 3x equals inverse secant of the quantity y minus the square root of 5 divided by 2. Last step here is to divide by 3, or multiply both sides by 1/3. Let's go ahead and multiply by 1/3. So now we have x equals 1/3 times inverse secant of the quantity y minus the square root of 5, all divided by 2. Now I do want to show one more variation of this. If we look at this step right here, remember secant and cosine are reciprocals of one another. So if secant 3x is equal to y minus the square root of 5 divided by 2, we could rewrite this in terms of cosine by saying cosine of 3x must be equal to the reciprocal of the secant function value. So we'd have 2 divided by y minus the square root of 5. And now instead of taking inverse secant on both sides of the equation, we'll take inverse cosine on both sides of the equation. And now inverse cosine of cosine 3x will equal 3x. The right side stays the same. We have inverse cosine of 2 divided by the quantity y minus the square root of 5. And now again, to solve this for x, we can divide by 3 or multiply by 1/3. And this is like 3 over 1. So this simplifies nicely to x. Then we have 1/3 times inverse cosine of 2 divided by the quantity y minus the square root of 5. So either of these would be acceptable, one involving inverse secant and one involving inverse cosine.